This just in, you were looking at obviously a very disturbing live shot there. That is the World Trade Center, and we have unconfirmed reports this morning that a plane has crashed into one of the towers of the World Trade Center.
Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September day? Were you in the yard with your wife and children, or working on some stage in L.A.? Did you stand there in shock at the sight of that black smoke rising against that blue sky? Did you shout out in anger and fear for your neighbor, or did you just sit down and cry? Did you weep for the children who lost their dear loved ones, pray for the ones who don't know? Did you rejoice for the people who walked from the rubble and sob for the ones left below?
Hypnotized standing up there. I'm not having time to react. Or I'm looking at this plane and it's getting bigger, bigger, bigger. Lord, I can't let you take over. And I dove under my desk.
That America today is on bended knee in prayer for the people whose lives were lost here, for the workers who work here, for the families who mourn.
But I know Jesus and I talk to God, and I remember this from when I was young. Faith, hope, and love are some good things He gave us, and the greatest is love. Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September day?
There's a bench for each of the 184 people who died here, starting with the youngest, 3-year-old Dana Falkenberg. She perished aboard the plane along with her 8-year-old sister Zoe and both parents.
A cavern.
And Frank just walked up to the edge. There was a big crater. And when I walked to the edge, he never said another word. And he never had to say anything.
There was hope in the midst of all of that decay. Somehow, in all of that darkness, God's light shone through.
Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September?